We find out today that military leaders in Afghanistan were illegally using Jedi mind tricks on visiting U.S. lawmakers to boost their support for the Afghanistan war. Now, that's the charge in another explosive Rolling Stone article on the U.S. military. Lieutenant General William Caldwell allegedly ordered a team of soldiers working on information operations, that's IO for short, to use their tactics on U.S. lawmakers illegally. Now, why would Caldwell take a risk like that? Well, Rolling Stone reporter Michael Hastings says, quote, the incident offers an indication of just how desperate the U.S. command in Afghanistan is to spin American civilian leaders into supporting an increasingly unpopular war. But when Lieutenant Colonel Michael Holmes got the order, he knew immediately something was wrong. This is what he told Rolling Stone, quote, my job in Psy-Ops is to play with people's heads, to get the enemy to behave the way we want them to behave. I'm prohibited from doing that to our own people. When you ask me to try to use these skills on senators and congressmen, you're crossing a line. In a statement to Rolling Stone, spokesperson for General Caldwell categorically denied the allegations. But let me tell you something. That is not just going over the line a little bit. That is massively over the line. You cannot do that to our congressmen and senators. You can't do that to citizens. It's illegal to do it to American citizens, let alone to our politicians. This is absolutely outrageous. Joining me now, of course, is retired Army Lawrence Wilkerson, and who, he, of course, served as the Chief of Staff for Secretary of State Colin Powell. Colonel Wilkerson, is this common or uncommon? I mean, is this happening behind the scenes all the time? We just don't find out because, you know, lieutenant colonels don't go around telling the reporters usually?
It's common that military psychological operations units try to spin the enemy, try to warp the enemy's mind, if you will, on the battlefield and elsewhere. It definitely is not common that they try to do that to Americans, and in fact, it's against the law.
How illegal is this? I mean, should there be a very serious investigation on Caldwell, among others?
There's a line between, you can talk about the Smith-Mundt Act, for example. There's a line between public diplomacy, as we say in the State Department, and public affairs. One goes to the American people, the other goes to the international community. That line has been made very vague by the internet. But at the same time, when you're talking about this sort of thing, if it's accurate, if Lieutenant Colonel Holmes is accurate in his allegations, then this is illegal and it shouldn't be being done. And yes, there should be an investigation.
You know, another thing that really disturbs me is what they did to Lieutenant Colonel Holmes. They then immediately started an investigation on him when he said, oh my God, look, I don't want to do this. I think this is wrong. What they do is they invented reasons. They say, oh, he went on Facebook too many times. He had the wrong clothes on. I mean, an absurd investigation. How often does that kind of strike back happen within the military?
Too often when you are in civilian terms a whistleblower, you get stomped on in the military. It's not like this is something new, though. Donald Rumsfeld tried this in the Pentagon. He tried to bring in Iran-Contra fame Vice Admiral John Poindexter and head up a strategic operations, a strategic information office in the Pentagon. That office's role would have been to spin the American people. So it's not like this is something new. I'm not that surprised in seeing it happen the way it's happened apparently in Afghanistan.
See, that was my concern during the Bush administration, that at some point we crossed a bridge where things that were previously radical became normal. And so do you think maybe the military's gotten the message through all of these years, hey, it's okay, we can influence Americans, maybe we can even influence American legislators. The guys upstairs don't seem to mind, they seem to like it.
I agree with you that we set some really bad precedents in the Bush administration, but I'd also say that when you spend 10, 11 years at war and you don't see a light at the end of the tunnel, then these sorts of things begin to develop, particularly when you're not winning in the traditional sense.
All right, Colonel, thank you for your time tonight. Really appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.
Joining me now is Robert Greenwald of Brave New Films. He's the director of Rethink Afghanistan. Robert, first thing I want to ask you is, how much money do they spend on nonsense like this?
Well, the size of the Pentagon's media empire would make many of us incredibly envious. They have over 27,000, almost at this, you're sitting down, I can see $1 billion on the combined efforts of the psychological operations and the so-called public bank. It's propaganda, and it's our tax dollars that are paying for it. Can you imagine how many salaries in Wisconsin could be paid with the money that's being wasted on propagandizing us and our congressmen?
Yeah, and that's the thing that drives me crazy. Republicans, some Democrats are always talking about, oh, we got to save money, we got to save money. Yeah, how about we save money by stopping brainwashing of our congressmen and senators? Now, but that goes to the second point. Any chance that this is effective, or are these just guys goofballs like going, ooh, Senator Franken, you will like the Afghanistan war?
Well, you know, it's a question of the level of intelligence of the elected representatives, which I won't comment on, and how effective this technique is. What I think is effective, because we're seeing it in Washington, is kind of bringing the elected officials and whispering in their ear and kind of telling them sweet nothings so that they feel they have an inside track. Because otherwise, how do you justify this war? The money, the killings, the terrible toll it's taken, the no sign of success. I mean, I don't know if it's hypnotism, but it's very hard to believe that any rational reason can now argue that this is a war that's making us safer.
Well, Robert, now we've got Republicans flipping. Huckabee, who's a major Republican candidate, possibly, saying, oh, you know what? I don't know why we're in Afghanistan. I can't figure it out, right? Same exact thing that you're saying. But here's my question. Why do the generals care so much? Why are they willing to possibly commit crimes to keep staying in Afghanistan for longer? I don't get that. What's their motivation?
Well, I think they do believe it. You know, it's like policemen who go and arrest innocent people because they once did something bad. The cops really believe they're doing the right thing. And I think, not to become a psychologist, which is the job of my brother and sister-in-law, but I think they believe what they're doing. On the other hand, with all this failure, with all this loss of life, and maybe most tragically, Cenk, you know, your guest before was talking about corporate control. We have to realize how far the military has invaded every sphere of our daily life. And the generals and the military have that power. They're not ready to let it go.
All right, Robert Greenwald of Brave New Films, thank you so much for joining us tonight.
Sure.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what, my take on it is a lot of these guys then wind up going working for the defense contractors, keep it real. I'm not saying that they think, okay, great, I'm going to do this just to get the money, but is that a relevant factor? I think it is. All right, that's our show for tonight. Thanks for watching. Hardball starts right now.